All right. Oh, wow. Just wore my couch out from sitting here and doing so much work. So I'm going to have to get that reupholsterized. But let me see how many people join in. Hello, Justin. Justin Smith. What state are you from? Justin, where's your city? What city are you from, Justin? What's up, TaylorMade? My hometown man from Crystal Springs, Mississippi. I don't think he's in Mississippi anymore. Thanks for tuning in. Look, I was not going to go live again. I've been live today. Phoenix City, Alabama. Okay. Phoenix City, Alabama. I was not going to go live today, but I'm doing some work. I'm wrapping up some work. And this is shiny. This is my iPhone 10, and I'm watching this video right on here. And I want to flip my screen because I had my old iPhone here anyway. So I want you all to listen and look at this video, and then I'm going to comment on it. This was on Instagram, so let me pull it up. See if I can multitask. Hold on for a sec. Dropped the phone. Maybe I can't. And so give me a second. While you're here, why are you in here? Drop your city and your state. Drop your city and your state, right? So let me pull this video up. I want to share with you. $100,000 is really $27,000.
You are lucky, let me if you got an agent, all right? You got NBA players, 450 plus NBA players, all right? How many of them are max players? How many of them are making it?
Think they're making it's not like that. And then this is me, this is where I go. I'm a little bit different than most in terms of what I'm willing to articulate. When I think about money, let's say for example somebody comes to me with $10 million, mm-hmm. I'm thinking 4.5,
right?
I'm thinking New York or California state taxes, federal, right? I'm at over 38%. Bring in the state income tax, you got FICA, right? Social security, disability, all this other stuff. You are lucky. And then if you got an agent, all right, which most of us do in this industry, and they're getting like 8 to 10%. What you're talking about is essentially walking away with 27 cents on the dollar. The other 73 is gone between taxes, agent fees, and stuff like that. And that 27 cents to the dollar, you're using that to pay your bills and to live your life. So when they come to you with that, don't get fooled by it. Don't get fooled by that overall number.
Right.
I always break it down. I think about, all right, what money comes to me? Don't talk to me about this dollar and I'm giving more than half of it to Uncle Sam and this and this. Nah, you know, you got to think about that. Well, if I'm thinking like that at age 51, and you thinking like that in your 40s or whatever, et cetera, what do you think a kid is doing at age 19, 20, 21 years of age when they get the money?
You think
it's $100 million, you're walking around spending like it's $100 million, and we ain't even getting the family and friends and close ones.
Wow, so
from people around you.
I could never, I don't care who I knew, I could know you guys are famous and got a lot of money. I could never walk up to you and say, hey man, I need $30,000. $30,000?
That's a lot of money.
No, see, you'd be amazed at like the large sums of money people ask you for. I had friends say, hey man, I want to buy a house. Can you give me $150,000?
All right, so let me cut that out. The point, what I wanted to share with you all was the interview that Stephen A. Smith done, and he talked about what $100,000 really equivalents to, what it really is, right? How much your real take home pay out of that. And oftentimes, you know, I post a question every now and then just to get the mindset of my friends and my followers on my Facebook page and my YouTube family. And I asked, would you rather have 100K in cash or 800 credit score, right? And this is why I'm asking, because we really need to be educated. Like Stephen A. Smith said in that interview, a 19-year-old child and you tell them, hey, I want you, I'm going to give you $100,000 cash, and they think that's a lot of money on the surface, right? But by the time Uncle Sam, and he said that in the video, you can go back and watch this replay, so you can catch that, right? By the time that Uncle Sam get his share, his taxes, that's why I tell people all the time, the name of the game is to learn how to save in taxes. Learn how adding a business entity, not your business, a business that teaches financial literacy and education components. Learn how adding that, especially if you work a job and you're a W-4 employee, will help you and save in your money that you get taxed in your taxable income. And so I was listening to a live video just on last night. It was about investing, right? Whether it's stocks, real estate, Forex, or whatever. And he made the comment, you know, I made a comment on the live thread that's why people need to get their credit scores up, right? Because if you are not a sixth in the upper class in America, and upper class income is anywhere above $150,000, more than likely, you do not have, and some people that even make $150,000, $200,000, $250,000, they don't have the cash, financial cash flow, or the statement to invest. Thank you for the digital love, right? And I also made a post that we often talk about, you know, making or earning money through a job, but we never learn how to position our money to make more money, right? You want your money to go out and find friends and come back and visit you so that your money can make more money. And that's this. I heard Robert Kiyosaki say one time that he does not depend on his FICO score, but he get millions of dollars from the bank, right? Because of his assets that he have and his income statements. They don't pull his credit report because he can say, hey, this is how much cash flow that I have coming in. This is how many assets I have. This is how many apartments I own. But you know what? A lot of us are not in that millionaire, billionaire status where we have so much cash flow coming in from our assets that the banks would give us millions of dollars to invest with. That's also debt free. Have you ever thought about that the money that you get from the bank in form of credit cards is debt free money, right? And you can invest in an asset like real estate. You can buy properties. And if you don't flip it and flop it, mean, you know, fix it up to resell. If you fix it up and you sell it, then you have to pay taxes on the capital gains. But if you fix it up and you hold it, if you buy and hold, that cash flow money that you have coming in will be taxed less. And people don't understand the power of credit and paying less in taxes. Even your payroll taxes, you have to start somewhere. Learn my W4 wealth strategy and learn how to use your credit, leverage your credit to get business credit cards, because I tell people all the time, it's much easier to qualify for business credit cards versus business loans, and it's also easier to qualify for business credit card than the hard money lending process, right? And even with hard money lenders, sometimes you have to have at least 20% of the down payment with the hard money lender because they don't want to be at risk. And then sometimes hard money lenders will only finance you up to 80%, you know, of the loan. So with business credit, you can get, or business credit cards, you can get 100% financing, and that credit card can be converted into cash through your banks, right? It's called balance transfers. You can get that done, and now you use that cash in your bank to invest in real estate, so you can have cash flowing coming in, and you can have multiple streams of income. And you can add to your financial future, because I state all the time, right, credit is for poor people. It's more so for people who don't have the money to get the bank's money, right? For people who can borrow the bank's money, get the bank's money, and invest in tools that will bring their money back in return. Because you have to have your money into something. You can't just have it sitting idle in the bank in a savings account and it's not earning, it's not growing, right? And the banks lend out your money as quick as you deposit it, right? Because money, cash, is a low-yielding process. So I just wanted to come on live real quick and say this. And since I have my laptop up, you know, I made a video earlier about this, but some of you all that's logged on tonight may not have seen it. Let me make sure this flasher is off. My flash is off. And, yeah, so these just some dispute results and that I was emailed today. And, you know, with my client, for this client, this was done the first time. It didn't take two or three rounds, right? Two or three rounds. This was a collection. This was eight accounts with Department of Navy and student loans that were deleted from her credit report. She's out of Florida, right? Florida. These are Department of Navy and student loans. It's eight of them. And then had two more collection. This is a medical collection and another. I think this was medical as well, right? So the very first time, just up, you know, doing some work, debriefing, want to come live, share that information with you that you need to use your credit, right, to create cash flow. You need to use your credit to create cash flow, right? And why cash is a very low yielding asset. As he said in the video, by the time Uncle Sam's FICA, Medicare, and your state taxes come out of it, and then they're printing out money faster than you can save it or spending, cash is not valuable. It's not valuable commodity, but it is a very important piece of commodity because you can still exchange cash for goods and services, right? But it's something that you need to take cash if you have it. If you want to invest your money, I don't want to invest my own money, but if you have it, invest in tangible assets. Invest in tangible assets. So 100K cash is not what you think it is, but your credit score, you can get over in the 700 range, will keep reproducing you money over and over, recycling over. Thank you for the digital love. Over and over and over and over again, you will have increased purchasing power. So make sure you get your personal credit on point today, because it takes you having great personal credit to qualify for the business credit, right? So hey, I'm signing out. This is the Queen of Credit, late night credit and cash flow conversations. If you're coming in at the end, please watch the beginning of this video, like and share it to your timeline. And if you want, hello Nana, hello, if you want any credit consultation from me, email me at LD, that's for Latonya Deloach, LD@fixmycreditandcash.com, LD@fixmycreditandcash.com. You all have a good night.